So, a quick update. Still running 5 links on my ED boy. Sword still not 6 links. Probably gonna try linking it soon, so I can get it on the jug. But I'm kind of hesitant on doing that because I kind of want to save my jewelers and a few things for a bow project, or if I ever get the tool chest. But yeah, on the I found an upgrade to my Trickster Boy. Now I'm running double Temple Rings, and this was like another 450 life, I think, from the old ring. I don't even remember what the old ring was. I think the old ring had like, no, it was more because the old ring had crafted life. I don't remember where it is now, but it had like crafted life only. So that was a lot of extra life. I finally ended up doing some of my emblems. Actually, I did two four ways and a bunch of three ways. Ended up getting 8 jewels in total. Couple the uniques. This is actually pretty nice because I'm not sure if it's a bug or not, but apparently right now you can link this with Spell Echo, and something like a Flame Golem actually. Basically, the Spell Echo doubles the Greater Spell Echo. I think it's probably not supposed to work like that. A couple of the Estus amulets, which I don't really have any plans on using, because I need stats from my amulet on my Estus, which we're gonna go hop into in a second. I did my fourth tool, so I've done three pure tools and one enriched, which I found when I was doing the emblems. I've literally just got them once from the tool. Toolstones, which is a bit feels bad, man. I found the total perfect movement speed belt. I found my first Wise Oak. I'm not sure if I'm gonna ever use it with anything, but I found that. And I found a disgusting, like, soul self minion helm, which kind of want, well, Tukohama helm to be more specific. I kind of want to play a spec, like a Spectre hybrid build where it's like I have a 6 link Tukohamas, and then I don't know, maybe golems if I ever get the jewels, which you can now farm with the primordial jewel, but I'm not sure if I want to do that. That could be something. Speaking of the temple stuff though, I have had now 5 jewels from the temple. And not a single one of the crit multi ones, which is a bit feels bad, man. Yeah. Let's go over to the SRS quick. I'm quickly gonna go over the setup and then show you a map, I guess. So I'm now level 87. Yep. I finished the bow pretty fast. I got the setup with the stronghold here, which I'm now taking off. I just had all of this influence. So what you need to do is you need to make sure that the surrounding maps have to be connected with Elder Influence. So Park and Bok had to be influenced, at least in this way of spawning it. And basically that meant that I wanted to have Val Pyramid, Defile Cathedral, Belfry, Crimson Temple, and Lighthouse also in under influence, because if any of these were Shaper influenced and it took away this or this map, that means that when running the gardens from Elder Influence, it will, instead of going to no influence, it will turn into Shaper Influence because one of the adjacent maps were Shaper Influence. So I just had a bunch of Elder Influence around here. At the end of this was Elder Influence, I run it out of influence, it went blank. Then I strength like run another map, usually it was strengthening my influence somewhere else. And then I think every single time in the first tick, the Shaper Influence spawned. And after like four. Yeah, I think it was four or three. Stronghold spawned. But the div card for the Porcupine, which is how I got my short bow, was way more common than I expected. And I ended up doing the map like, I don't know, less than 10 times with the Stronghold, and got it. And this was crafted using Shrieking Essence of Rage, which gives +2 fire gems, and I think I did it like 3 times. I just used it until it had two prefixes and two suffixes, where one at least one of the suffixes were something useful, so in this case dexterity. Then you craft it with cannot roll attack modifiers. So then it had like then it was three suffixes, so the exalt can't roll a suffix, and there's only one prefix available, and that's a plus one all gems. So we did that and then crafted the attacking cast speed there. And now we have SRS, minion damage, melee splash, empower, faster attacks, and melee physical there. I ideally Warichi white socket this and hope that the green goes in it either to blue or red. And yeah, right now I'm not using Unleash because I don't really have issues devouring the item, stealing my corpses. I don't really have issues maintaining max SRS ever. This is just with a flesh offering, no onslaught from a flask or no wall haste right now. And I'm not like, whenever I, you know, increase the gas speed for each corpse, consumed corpse. So even if I consume a lot of corpses, I still, you know, I'd get even more gas speed. Other than that, the setup is, so we have the Anime Guardian is using Dying Breath, which is allies to near like the increased damage, and then there's some curse effect. He has a Scorched Fossil crafted helm for minus 9 fire resist. Is using Blood Bond, this chest piece, for the life regen and the pretty high increased life. The minion life and the minion dodge doesn't actually do anything. It's literally just the increased life and the right life regen there that applies to it. But since he has a decently high base HP, the percentage is really great. Now, obviously, this isn't the best in slot. You could very easily make a better, like an elder chest piece or something like that. But that's a decent chest piece. Then we have a random ass golem for some meat shields and some regen. My setup right now with the devouring item is generosity, precision, hatred, and then I have one, you know, not generosity haste there. Eventually, when I take this node, which might be even the next level, I'm actually planning of dropping discipline and putting anger in my helm, and then just having a precision somewhere else, and I can actually still manage to hit the accuracy cap with that. Using Grip of the Council as planned, using the chest that I showed in the previous video. I have two minion speed crafted rings done with Essence of Fear. I'm using the Rare Guard with Rare Guard and the Lethal Bride with Kiloava. I have Glancing Blows for, you know, double the block, so I'm permanently 42 attack blocks and 26 spell block. If I use Bone Offering, level 19 Bone Offering, it gets me to 75 and 60. I could also use Rumis instead, but right now I need my flask suffixes, which comes to the boots, which were crafted using Bound Fossil. Until I got the Spectre suffix and a good suffix, and then I just cleaned out the prefixes and multimodded. If I had the mod here for Avoid Freeze, so the rank 3, I'm one off from rank 2, and the rank 3, which is Rin's boots, only boots dropped by Rin can give that, would be freeze immune. And then I could drop my freeze immune from my flask, and then I would just, you know, I would use a, I would get the curse immune into my silver flask and use Rumis instead, which is really nice for mapping. Obviously for bossing I want to use Bone Offering for permanently having the block gap, on attack block at least. Rare Guard, some random ass amulet with life, resistant, that's pretty much it. And then just a belt with some ES life and some resistances. This isn't ideal, I want to get rid of this at some point, but we'll see when it's gonna happen. As for the skill tree, everything is pretty much the same except I decided that I want to use a another spectre, which kind of made me go away from this pathing and taking the Essence Surge. Sadly, the Glancing Blows doesn't give me anything useful on the melding. These are just 4 strength and, you know, 2 strength nodes, like 2 extra strength from the pathing nodes. I'm actually gonna respec these 3 points into the Mana Jewel and then Piercing Acclamation later, because Influence gets 20 strength. I could also repath these 2 nodes into here, which would mean that I would have to drop these 5 nodes as well. But I could put them into life or life plus 4 side right now or something like that. So it's not really a terrible idea, but I don't like the hybrid nodes right now. And if I were to do that, I could take this for the recharge rates, which I don't really feel like I need in a mapping. But mainly because this specific jewel right now with this seed gives me 4% life here, which is really nice. Yeah, that missing a jewel, missing another jewel, and another jewel there. I'm missing influence. And yeah, like I mentioned, once I get this node, which might probably be even next level, I can drop the discipline. I really feel like I don't need. Sure, it gives me like 600 ES, but I really don't. I just feel real. I don't feel like I need it. It's a nice amount of defenses, but whenever I get to upgrade this gain 6% into 10%, which is a Gravicious craft. As you can see, this is Gravicious. It's rank 1 only. This shit can give me, at the max roll, can give me, if I have 6k life, which is totally doable with some level ups and getting some life nodes. That's why I'm actually thinking about respecing this, because I could get more life nodes, like just pure life nodes, because life nodes also scale my ES through the mod here. So yeah. And I'm gonna get a lot of damage. I think the anger is like 20 to 30% more damage or something like that. But yeah, I think we went over all the stuff. Let's quickly run a map. Showcase how it plays. It's not the greatest monolith farmer, but in maps like this where the monoliths can't really open into, you know, million different directions, it's not that bad. So as long as the SRS doesn't like have a million places to go, it feels really smooth. But yeah, basically just cast every SRS every now and then, and yeah, usually a convocation on tanky boys to get a nice little single target, because the Scorching Ray totems, not only do they do damage, they lower the resistances of monsters, which means my SRS will do more damage. I just really want to show you how the monolith goes in a map like this. And I'll talk about the other setups as well a bit, like the gem setups. As you can see, I'm using GMP, and that's mainly because of the AoE needed for monolith. For single target, like boss fights, you could easily, like, I would probably end up using Stormbrand and plus Cooling Strike instead of GMP Ball Lightning, or could even use Onslaught for getting that permanent Onslaught for boss fights without needing a flask, which is really nice. Sadly, right now, my SRS, not SRS, my Spectres are only a 3 link, because I'm, you know, pretty dry on sockets. But that could be solved by getting a Hungry Loop, which is why I am chancing Undead Rings, because that would allow me to have a 5 link on them, and then I could link my anime guardian with minion life, which would make him really tanky and basically never die. Yeah, here we have a monolith. So what I usually do is I'll just make sure I get my Estrus up. Pop it, pop my wall haste. Now we even have a general here. So in maps like this, it's actually not bad at all. But with maps that are like super open, but as you can see, the anime guardian is taking a bit of damage there. And that's just because he doesn't have the base life to get. Oh, nice. That's actually the reason why I'm kinda in here. It's because of that div card. I'm talking about it in the past, I believe. Yeah. It's actually one of the few red maps I've done, so I'm a tiny bit scared of him. But yeah, he should go down there soon. Probably wanna start running the block at some point. But yeah, as you can see, as long as the monoliths don't like open like in, well, basically if you're doing like super open maps, Ezreal is not the greatest. But for like closed maps and like semi-closed maps like the lair, it's totally fine. I basically opened everything on there. And I'm not running this out on purpose. I don't really have any plans on keeping this as a stronghold, as you can see. Mainly because I prefer being able to drop Shaper and Elder items while mapping. For various reasons. And that's why I run it out. But yeah, I've been enjoying Ezreal a lot. Devouring Diadem. And here you can see it's stealing my corpses. Soon. Every time that happens, that's 400 life and energy shield per corpse. But just using Desecrate once gives like 2k both. I assume it consumes everything, which is insane. Sustain for mapping. Exile. Like honestly, you probably don't even need Wicked Ward if you have a reliable way of getting corpses. Like, you could do like a setup where you have, instead of going a bow here, and you'd use like a MAME chest that was corrupted for like, you know, duration gems or something like that. It's pretty nice. You could do something like that and then have use socketed skills on use, which is given like a 4 or 5 second cooldown, and you could have like desecrate there or something like that. And that would be insane for your Devouring Diadem. Basically, Devouring Diadem slash plus Wicked Ward is insane and amazing mana sustain on basically anything. Like I'm probably gonna be using this setup and this combo on a lot of builds to come in the future, like casting builds. It's just so nice and allows you to. This basically means also that no region maps are doable for casting builds, because you don't need leech, because recharge rate is not regen, so it doesn't do anything to that. So it's just really nice. Yeah, hopefully I'll get quite a bit of more Mad Kings and then a Nepulox, because there's another build I have my eyes on already. It's too many builds I want to play right now. It's crazy. But yeah, I'm enjoying the SRS. Probably gonna be not shelving, but put it in line after I hit maybe like 92 or something like that, because I really wanna get the Hungry Loop, get a 5 link Spectre for some extra bossing DPS and then test some endgame content with it, I think. And for farming, the ED Contagion is just so much better and so much safer that I'd rather do it with that. I can do like T16s. I can like face tank some of the monolith shits in T16 with like multiple damage mods because that's how crazy my evasion is and the survivability of that dude. It's just bonkers. And it gets a free rarity basically because of the Contagion. Either way, hope you enjoyed the little showcase of me talking about this shit. Oh, actually, I guess quickly, I'm using increased duration on Flesh Offering and Steel Skin. I originally had cast with damage taken, but I feel like better to just self-cast it if you have the sockets. And that allowed me to have a Golem for some extra regen, and it's a meat shield, and it actually does a lot of damage too. And yeah, Flesh Offering with increased duration is a lot of people don't do it because they don't have the sockets, but these two links are just like insane because Flesh Offering gets, you don't actually see it right there, but Flesh Offering gets base duration per corpse, and that base duration gets scaled up by your increased duration. So if you have like a one duration cluster for it's like 45%. A 2020 duration is like 70 something, is it like 75% or something like that? I don't know, which is just like insane extra duration you can get. And then the Ball Lightning GMP with Curse and Elemental Weakness, and yeah, one socket flame doesn't disintegrate, and that's pretty much it. I'm gonna see you guys later.